Kubrick, you know, for a long time had the studios in Hollywood did not really appreciate Kubrick. They knew he was a winner, but they never knew what he was going to do. He was the most unpredictable producer going. And so they hired him. They contracted him to do a lot of big pictures. But they never knew and held their breath when he went into production what was going to happen. Usually it was pretty good. He just had an innate knowledge of how to make a picture work. And some of the people were lined up. The biggest stars in Hollywood were lined up to work for him. They didn't care what the money was. They just wanted to work for Kubrick. He was a lovely man. I remember just at the beginning of the production, I mean, he had people like Peter Sellers, George C. Scott, Keenan Wynn. I mean, these chaps could start revolutions. I mean, they were really quite extraordinary. The firepower that they had between them was immense. He somehow managed to have the meeting out of his hand. They just appreciated this incredible talent and also the understanding he had. He said, if you got a problem, don't try to solve it yourself if it's too difficult. Come to me, we'll work it out. I mean, this is very unusual for a Hollywood director. They just want to get the picture over with and give themselves as many kudos as possible. But Kubrick was a man's man.
Of all the remarkable pieces of cinema he gave us, why do you think Dr. Strangelove is so often hailed as one of his finest and most enduring, timeless achievements?
It broke a lot of rules. And I think that was it. It also had this immense cast who never let up. I mean, they had a good script to work with, but they fed off each other. I've never seen a group of actors who gave so much to each other, and nobody was trying to be a star. Even Sellers, who was accused sometimes of doing that. They were just handing things to each other to pick up the baton and get to that finish line. And it worked. I mean, it was mesmerizing, the work that he turned out. It really was.